section right there.
Huh?
It's a cool little section. It's a drag.
The top?
Huh?
The thing right here.
The pin? Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
Helping with somebody on four wheeler. Everyone's supposed to be here. No bodies laying around, right?
So you have hunters come on here?
No. No hunters. Ready? No, I'm behind you, man.
No.
You know the deal.
No.
Come on, Darren. Go ahead, you show us how it's done. I'm the medic.
You pick up parts?
Yeah. Body parts, bicycle parts, DNA scrapings.
There's a few of them back
here. There is. I've got plenty of them out here. Thank you. Hold up.
Sorry.
I was trying to
knock you off.
I was trying to knock you off.
I nicked you.
That's nice coming down, isn't it?
Yeah. I need more air in my back tires. Those hard traverses. That rear tire, you can feel it going. Sitting my butt on the seat.
Well, part of this Sunday race series we're thinking of having is going to be tire air pressure handicaps. You know, really good riders going to have like 5 pounds of air in their tires.
My trouble with mine, if I don't have these types of I'm blowing air out of the tires, hitting stuff.
Oh, you mean you'll burp a tire?
Huh?
You'll burp a tire.
Yeah, the front tire, I didn't have enough air in it. I was up at Danville on that witchback, and I was on downhills turning and hitting this little rock with the front.
Yeah.
And it went,
burped a tire.
Yep.
I burped the tire out here 2 weeks
ago. I'm like, what the heck is this?
Yeah.
And it's because I got to put more air in the tires around here.
I know it's extra weight, but it's a pump and a CO2 cartridge.
I have a CO2 cartridge back in here.
Yes, I burped it. I burped a tire up there the other last
you
week.
Did?
And didn't have enough. I had him walking back.
Yeah, I can keep everything around. I'm wasting another 2 pounds.
I got two canisters with me.
If I lost 5 pounds, that would make the difference of carrying
If you took
pounds.
A crap before you came out and rode, that would offset
that makes
the
it
pack,
able.
You know. Don't eat for about a day and a half. You know, you can figure out how to lose a couple of ounces here and there.
We're in Colorado, I had a chain fixer. extra links. I carried all this crap. And guess what? We'd use it.
Yep. I bet you did out there.
Yep. We'd be back on something if we might break a chain.
Well, usually we carry Matt with us. He's got all that stuff in his pack.
He carries it? Yeah. So I don't carry the chain. See, around here, you can really walk out. Because
when he's
not
here.
Like all the way in and then all the way back out. One shot. You know, you can get out.
When he's not here, we get nervous. That's where I took the header.
Get those, you know,
and that shit, you know, did you see that picture on Facebook? It was back there a little ways, and the four-wheeler rolled off backwards down in that ditch, one of these ditches.
That one you own?
Yeah.
That doesn't have
no
brakes?
Yeah. I was backing up in reverse, and then usually you can shift to forward before you need to stop, right? It was going too fast, so I was grinding. I bailed halfway down, and my head stuck straight in that bottom.
Oh, shit.
Up to my shoulders. It's like, you know, Stone Age peat down in there, you know?
Crap.
And anyway, my phone was underwater for a minute. And that shit. I'm fishing around for it. Walked out. Just called my son. I pulled my damn four-wheeler out of the mud that you gave me. With no brakes.
Yeah, what's it? Does that thing, the brakes are just gone? Or are they broke?
They're broke. It's got a drum on the rear axle that was froze on there, and somebody tried to cut the drum off one time, and it's just like screwed the whole axle up. And I was, you know, it's just a beat around thing. I think I'm going to just rig me up a disc brake off of something, you know, off of like a motorcycle or something.
Yeah.
Something will work.
Well, yeah, you
I can fabricate
all
shit.
Kinds of crap. So
yeah. After that, after doing that, I think I'd better do something about it.
Because I've been on it before, you know, and really, if you pay attention.
Yeah.
But when you get up and you have to back up, you've got to make sure you back up so that the tree stops you or something, you know.
The only reason I even came down this way to do that was because Chuck was cutting through here. Instead of going around them roots across the top, and I got pissed off. You hear that? Chuck was cutting straight through here. So I came down here that day and put all them branches across so you had to go around the tree like you're supposed to. And then I went in the drink. So it was my fault.
You see that big rock right down there?
Yeah.
That's what I got tangled up in. Well,
I thought you were got
Which
caught
rock?
In the tree.
Which one?
That right next to the log, except when I rolled down the hill.
Oh.
It was farther up a hill, and I hit that jerk in the back end, rolled off of it. Next thing I know, the bike's standing straight up.
Well, you've got a how not to dismount a bike tape, don't you, somewhere?
No, I got a whole mix.
All right, let's go. All right, we've got two more improvements you get to see on the way.
What's this thing doing down here?
The pull cord's busted.
What is?
Pull cord. Two more improvements to look at. Centrifugal clutch. Tip of the day, don't ride behind your buddy after he ate a pot of Pintos the night before. My buddy Brad Hall, the other night we were riding through here, I swear I smelled sewage plant or something. He's laughing the whole time, you know. I mean, that's pretty bad when you can stink up the outdoors. Left. Too many people complaining about it.
You're kidding me. You know what though, they'll always complain about it, so good for them.
No, I couldn't ride it.
I like it. I like the rocky stuff.
It's gonna come back.
That guy that did the trails and they'd be all these people bitching about stuff.
Yeah.
And you go, people, man, what do you want to do? If you want to ride the pavement, go ride the pavement.
Yeah. That was just a tough spot to get out of.
I like it.
I know. But
you ruined it.
I didn't ruin it.
Huh?
It'll come back.
You ruined it.
It'll come back. Sorry. I knew you were going to be mad. The guy in front of you is one of the ones that wanted to cut. And I took this tree out that was right here, too. Told you.
I figured it would be.
Yeah, I like that. Nice.
Well, Darren didn't like it, and you liked it.
Who didn't?
Darren.
You didn't like that?
Give me a shot and put it on the back. I might like it a little better.
That's why it's a short distance.
I always spin going up there. That's
so,
why. But not anymore. I'll put some rocks on there.
I can't ride there anymore.
I'll put some rocks on there.
I look forward to that.
Well, look, we're going to be starting on the back 40. In the fall, I'm just going to make a trail straight up that hill there.
Well, I can't go straight up. You have to zigzag.
So you know he's done backtracking.
Yeah, right. A minute ago, oh, it's too easy. Now, wait a minute. I see how it is.
Well, that, you know, the other section over there is pretty good pull. And then when you think you get to the top, then it's got the next section, right?
Yeah.
But it gives you a little slack in there a second so that you can get your legs back under you. And then you can pull the second one. And realistically, you can put a third one in there.
Kind of too late. I've already ordered the ski lift.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, for the downhillers. Because the downhillers are complaining about it too. But it's a good, I mean, if you can get where you can ride that back up there, you're doing something. I mean, all the way up, I think. At least me. That's my goal. I did ride the fire road all the way up the other week.
So if you give us a break, you've been to that hot tamale in Danville?
I never heard that.
You haven't?
I don't like
it. It's really a long pull, and some days I have to go like to sit on a freaking log because it doesn't give you a break once you get really steep for quite a while. But you know, you get going, and then when you get a little bit of a break, you know, where it's not so steep, and then you start out again and do it again, you can add another one on there. But you got to give it a little flat spot so people can get their legs back in there, and then go again.
Did you come to MST with us yet? Yeah, you gotta go down there sometime.
What's that?
MST. Moore Springs.
Oh, yeah. Is that what you call that?
Yeah.
That's
MST.
Cool.
It's real rocky, though. If you think there's rocks here.
Yeah, in the fall, it's really hard because the rocks are hit by the leaves. And the leaves are really bad.
That's why I got this scar on my knee over here.
I got lost in there I usually can take my dogs there because there's nobody there. And frick, I got lost in there where I couldn't even see the trail.
You been on Rattlesnake?
I went that day that...
Oh, you were with us? Yeah. That's right, yeah.
Well, I didn't make the turn.
That's right, I forgot, I'm sorry. It's pretty hairy.
Going up that one part where that little rock stick out, it was just so steep going up. The other guy that rode really good.
Lewis.
What's his name?
Lewis.
Yeah, he tried right it again. I said, you can do it, but you can't be in first gear because you can't get enough momentum to get over that. So he did in the second, and I think he made it.
He came down.
But it was a steep pull at first.
He came down the Rattlesnake and went off that ledge like down and then made the turn right below it. He came right off the
that rock.
Yeah, well, you were there.
I was the one that told him, you got to go to the outside. Yeah. Because the inside,
he went inside.
It was too steep to
skid. He did it three times, inside, over the rock, and the outside.
But you told me that guy before, that older guy that went before, went on the inside.
Yeah.
See, when I went to go and I seen the inside, I went, crap, I can't hold this because my seat.
Right.
I'm going to be on that seat. I can't get back off that thing far enough.
Yeah, and you had to be way off.
Yeah, you had to be way off of it.
That's where Huck felt wrecked. You don't have Facebook, but his Facebook profile picture. With him wrecking, with his ass up there and arms flailing.
He was there?
On the Rattlesnake in that curve coming down.
That's the only thing I did, couldn't ride down though, was that turn. And I probably could ride it if I went there again.
I had trouble with that slick rock. That green rock going through the water.
Everybody did.
Okay, good.
Yeah. No, you weren't the only one. The guys in front of me did. And what I did was I made sure I stayed straight. Mm. So I got me cockeyed. Down here, so that when I went across, I got up high. So when I went across, I went straight across.
Yeah.
It didn't slip out at all. But every one of them had trouble that was ahead of me.
Yeah.
Because they try and turn in it to get out.
Yep.
Yeah, and you couldn't turn.
It was green rock, man.
It was too slippery.
Dead.
I seen them bailing out right there, and I went across. So I got up the hill and then dropped into it this way, and I just went straight across. I couldn't even tell it was wet. You know, because it was straight. It was a turn in it, is what was wrong. So you come out and you go to turn in the water, and then there's a little ledge coming out. Well, everybody's making that turn, then they're trying to do something with power. It was really slippery, slimy.
You guys ready?
It's all the dope there, right?
Yeah, not too bad.
I have to go get some.
Actually, no, then once
you
go
get some.
Some what?
Water to wash those rocks back up.
They'll come out. Don't worry about it. I'll tell you what, I'll one half of it, I'll coat it with loose rock.
Put one big ass rock right in the middle.
I'll do something for him. I feel bad. I knew he was going to whine and piss and complain about it.
Yeah, I'm going to piss and complain about that.
Yeah,
that
and I knew Darren would be happy because he made it up there.
I made it up at this time.
Yeah.
It was a fun one because it's hard.
It's hard to please everybody, is all I can
say. It is. Well, when I was cutting trail with Chuck that time, he was trying to knock down those humps.
Yeah.
I go, no, leave them here.
Yeah, I go,
after you learn how to ride, you'll find out they're fine.
That's right. I'm good. I like humping.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. We're
almost home.
No, ain't no reason.
No.
But that there, I'm telling you, you're about the only one I know that ever made it up it.
Oh, really? I like it. It's very challenging.
Yeah, it'll wash out. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.